Here we go, people. This is a Smith AM meter. Okay. What we got up in front of the camera there is one of those ones where someone's gone in there, had a little monkey around, shall we say, and decided to have a little play around with things. Okay. Evidence of that includes no anti-tamper seals on it. Okay, and also someone has had a pop at the terminal screws, at the terminal cover screw. It's been melted. Okay, they've obviously tried to either remake the anti-tamper seal, or they've tried melting little holes so they can remove the anti-tamper seal in order to undo that and bypass the wiring underneath. And also inside, if you know what Genevas are, they've obviously lifted up the Genevas and disengaged them so that it doesn't record anything. And yeah, I've spent the last hour or so trying to re-engage those Genevas because, well, basically, I couldn't see what I was doing, so I just had to give it a bit of guesswork, and I managed to line up all of Genevas in a straight row so that they were lined up properly, and then click them back into place. And as such, I've had to reset the reading on it. Okay. So, yeah, and also this one doesn't have any characteristics because it's supposed to be there and it's been removed. So the only thing I know about it is the type AM, single phase, 50 cycles. Okay, so I'm going to give this one a characteristic set of probably 40 amps max, because a lot of Smith meters were 40 amps max, 240 volts, and I would seem to think this one's got 300 revs on the load wheel. Okay, we're going to give it a 0.1 kilowatt hour accuracy test right now. I've had the battery light come on, so I'm going to have to strike this right up. My any loop ones are playing up again. So let's just get on with it. I've got a kettle as a load. And yeah, let's just strike this right up. Okay, it's off. And here we go. Yep, that's whacking around in there at a decent speed. And yep, the Sangamo Schlumberger SPA02 on the metering board is running properly. Okay. So here we go. So yeah, this one's had a right little play around with inside. I've had to reset the reading on it, re-engage the Genevas. And yeah, this one is made by Smith Meters Limited in Dunblane, which is up north in Scotland. It says on there, made in Scotland. Okay. There's 0.04 in it to go. Can it do it? I'm hoping these batteries hold out. .02. Okay, I'm getting ready on the switch. Okay, that's it. Has it done it? Let's have a look. The load wheel's just coming around, and if I can minimise that glare on the... Well, there we go. There it is. Yeah, I would say that's a pass. It's pretty much there. Okay. So it says 0.1 on it. Load wheel's almost come around. So, yeah, I'd say that's a pass. Okay. So, yeah, judging by what's been going on inside that, it's no surprise that no one else bid on it. Because in the auction, it did actually show that meter with these terminal, these case screws removed, and they were just by the side on the table. And, yeah. But that is one of the ones I wanted in my collection. And I took a gamble on it anyway. Nice price. And for what it took for me to realign the Genevas, you know, it's child's play. If I restored the British Sangamo HM and got that going again, sorting it out, it's child's play. So, you know, I've just gone past 6 minutes. It was supposed to be a 6 minute video because of these batteries. I don't want to lose this footage. So, yeah, 6 minutes and 15 people. Thanks for watching.